Hello, it's me, Dark, Tom, and we're doing a cab ride on the DR because I want to show everyone the actual full route, even though I've uploaded a video just to say show a little bit of the route. Yeah, so I've got some people with me tonight. Everyone say hello, or whatever it is you'd like to say.
Hey.
There you go.
Hello.
You want us to
Hi.
scream?
I'm going to say something last because I waited my turn like a good little boy.
Well,
No,
you
you
didn't.
didn't.
Bullshit!
So hopefully I can sync up the video with the audio and recording. We'll see how that goes. I'll start off the video by saying hello. We're in the cab of 47527 at Mearcombe, and we're going to be going from here to Horton, and then we're going to be reversing at Horton to go to Hitchin Abbas. And if I bring the route map up, so hopefully I can sync my video from there. We're basically going from the top of the map all the way to here at Horton. Then we're going to run round and go all the way down here, and then at the end of that, we're going to see how long this route actually fucking is. That's going to be nice, isn't it? Ooh. So anyway, because I'm driving a diesel, let's get started. Meow. So anyway, everyone think of a topic of discussion, and I'll tell you to shut up when I've got a thing to say about part of the route. Which is
Yes,
right,
well,
which
do.
is which is right now actually, because look, there's a good shed. Oh my god, it's a good shed. Anyway, carry on.
Wow.
I've got a good topic. That's Tom's fetish for good sheds.
I swear to God, if you say something about flying Kaufman.
I have
It's funny
one.
he says that.
Oh.
So what's everyone's opinion on their new happy stuff that's coming out for train sim, like the Y14, the Adams Radial, and all that, and the N2, and all that lovely stuff?
I will point out,
Love
because
shit.
nobody actually said who they were, that was Glenn.
Yes, that was Glenn. Sorry.
Hello, Glenn.
Hi.
Is it me you're looking for? Anyway, what was this
now.
about new stuff coming out?
So, what's everyone's opinion on the new DT and rustic engine and carriage workshop and
I'm
mesh
fucking
tools
motion.
loveliness?
Mine.
Don't forget Victory Works, my nine.
Oh yes, very true.
I don't think I have enough capacity in certain organs to show my appreciation.
Oh.
There's always your hand to show appreciation.
Oh
I
God.
hear you. I hear you, Thomas. What about the new Black Five? There's your topic.
Oh dear, that's a
Yeah.
topic.
Oh,
Oh,
Bossman
that
Production.
is.
Bye,
That
making
is.
chair.
What's also another topic is why the bloody hell does not Railworks not want to let me click on this bloody engine?
Well,
Anyway, carry on as you were.
there's a variety of reasons for that, Bruce, and that's because you've got a fat head.
Ah, that's why I can't fit through the cab door.
Excellent.
Bruce is not in loading gauge.
Oh, Chignall, can you please turn green for me? Yay, thank you. Oh God, enough of Bruce's laugh, please. It hurts.
Why?
It just hurts.
Oh, sorry. I'll be a miserable soul for the rest of my life.
Yay!
Be a
I'm happy about this.
stereotypical Midlander, Bruce. This isn't working very nicely.
Bingham.
Bloody
This
hell,
is
this
really
bloody
shit.
game is absolutely shite. It ain't working.
Bloody hell, traffic's a misery.
I've lost my
Why has Bruce suddenly become Scottish?
It's not Scottish, it's
That's not
Birmingham.
fucking Scottish, it's Brummie.
What have you got on the Scottish, yeah?
Scottish? If you think that's Scottish, then Welsh must be bloody Swahili to you.
It's a very tame Scottish.
Oh look, it's
Is
the
he the
remains of
Scottish?
the remains of the industrial branch. Bye.
Lol. Hi,
it's all gone.
Leander.
I can point out extreme Scottish for our polite Scottish. Sam.
Alright.
Yes. How are you, chap?
I'm nae bad, Bruce. I'm very Scottish. I'm very rude.
Good.
Morning.
What Morning.
The fuck you see, I'm this scared you fight me, please!
Wait.
I believe my social experiment has worked.
Did you
oh,
say, fight me, please?
Who's fighting me here?
Please fight me, I can't handle the rejection.
Fight me in IRL.
Alright, I will.
Dearie
right
me.
In the nine.
Oh, no,
you know
well.
What? I'm going to go in scenario editor.
Well,
I'm
let's get you.
Put down a different engine because I can't click on this one.
By the way, even though again I put it in the other video, look at Manchester Four Station. It's your Manchester Four skin.
Oh. Tom, I can't see it.
Well, I know you can't bloody see it, but you'll see it in the actual video, you cheesy player.
Right.
God, jeez.
Yeah, stop being such a what's it, please.
Yeah, stop being Scottish, for Christ's sake. Oh. Actually, in fairness, if you can't stop being Scottish, then we need to try and at least make Oliver not Australian and upside down.
Oh. Oh.
Would that mean deporting him from Australia?
But like with his ancestors.
Oh.
Well, no, they were brought in.
In fairness, if you guys can raise like £15,000, yeah, I'll move to England.
Right, Oliver's having a new Patreon campaign.
Yes.
It's www.olivermeetsdrugmoney.co.uk.
/ oh my god, we're about to crash.
Come here.
Ah.
Ah. I thought there'd be more actual topics going on here, but clearly not.
TS World. I'm guessing not.
Let's talk about TS World, Gwion.
Oh, TS World. Yes, TS World is coming out. As the beta, of course. It's a 12-day beta. And,
is that it?
It's a 12-day beta. To be honest, a lot of other games that are out there, much high profile, only have a 2-day beta. I think Planet Coaster comes to mind. I think that had a weekend beta. Or was that... No, Roller Coaster Tycoon World. That had a weekend beta. It's very common for that kind of thing. But it's basically going to be small extracts of particular parts of the route that they've been working on. And it involves one of the locos. They all look the same, to be honest, in my opinion. That's just me being blatant.
That's racist.
That's me being blatantly non-caring about American locos there, because obviously there's something different. There's going to be some Malarek out there going, that one has an extra large cylinder, it knows.
Kind of reminds me of GWR engines, how they look the same.
Get to fuck.
Yeah, so that's coming out tomorrow, and I'll be messing around with it. I hope to do a couple of videos. I've got my first desktop I built about 8 years ago at the office at the moment. Needs a graphics card, but once that's in there, I'm going to do some videos on that as well, just to see how well it runs on a really old computer.
That'd be quite interesting, actually.
Exactly. Well, I'll try and do a comparison as well with current train simulator on there, because I might have run it. But yeah, of course I did. I did run train sim. I used to run train sim on there in the past, but that was like back 2013 edition and things like that. Earlier than that, probably. Rail sim, I did play on it. So it'd be interesting to see if TS World will at all. It's a dual core processor, so maybe not. It might run, but not very well. It's to be seen, basically. But it will be using a lovely 770 graphics card, which is, you know, it's pretty modest. It was the dog's bollocks about 3 years ago. So
what, the 710?
No, the 770.
Gwion talking about things I don't understand again.
it was just like the top card. Like it was the decent enthusiast card, because it was a very good price point. But you can buy them today for less than £100. So if it can play Railworks, then it's worth a buy. But there are more modern graphics cards which are just as good, so maybe not. The 1050 sounds very good.
Yes, but not all of us have
Sorry, if it's an enthusiast card, does that mean when you boot it up, it goes, "My lord"?
Oh, for Christ!
does it flail?
You shout English Electric out a window behind the fact you want a load of Sulzer fans on the opposite track.
But I was definitely like,
more importantly, Bruce, does it bellow? Anyway.
Yeah, I'll be definitely interested to see how well it performs, though, because, well, Train Sim's been an absolute joke for performance.
Oh, when I speak about performance, I've got major stuttering at the moment in the video, so that's very good, very good.
Well, if you want to reduce that stuttering, you know what the viewers must do, don't you?
Oh, yeah, time for our annual. It's annual plug. Annual plug.
Anthony, play the commercial.
Are you tired of paying for your car insurance?
Are you tired of Tom's videos looking like utter shit? Did you want Tom to make it look a lot better? Then support him on Patreon! Unless you're poor, in which case, get the fuck. Uh-huh.
£1 a month, you can help Thomas Gibden.
Yeah, $1 a month. you can help Tom out and get exclusive content before other people, and
such as dick pics.
Disclaimer: no actual pics will be shared of that agenda, of that nature.
Aww. Yeah, sorry for everybody who wanted one, but I'm afraid no, that's not going to happen.
No, you just send them the pictures of the panniers.
No, what? Tom, just, yeah, exactly. Just send a picture. Oh, by the way, with some major stuttering, Woolchurch Viaduct, everybody, and also Lake Village over there. Look, it's wait. If I go to the outside camera view, and skip across to the actual one that works. There we go. Look, it's a village over there on the shakes, on the shores of the lake. Anyway, back to the cab. No, back to the studio.
Come on, 4,300, you're up the fucking hill.
No.
Now the most random topic ever. Can someone quickly help me? Because I'm peeing about something. Does anyone know what...
You're peeing about on something. Oh, for God's sake, Bruce. Stop getting your knob out for everything. Christ.
Yes, I know. What does the Corris Railway come under to enable the...
SHG.
Are you sure it's not Corris Railway?
No, it's SHG in the editor.
What, Shag?
Yes. No, SHG, not FHG.
Are you sure it's
Sierra
not...
Hotel Golf?
Yeah.
Oh,
what the fuck
there.
Was that sound?
Hmm. What, have you tried looking under Welsh shite? Oh.
Freddie, you controversial bastard.
That was triggered. That was completely uncalled for, Freddie, and I'd like your resignation.
But I've been on the force for 15 years.
Oh, well.
Oh.
Well, that's long enough. Off you go.
Oh.
Ah, the stutter's real. Just move! Oh, I hate this.
Yes,
every
that
time
was clever,
I try, every time I try and record a video, this happens. It's like it's just basically buffering to load Siri on the next stupid fucking tile, and it's so annoying.
Yeah.
What do you guys think of the Terriers?
They look good.
Controversially, I'm not that bothered.
Oh.
Active silence. Mate. Slight pause.
Well, firstly, I'm excited because it's going to have so many bloody modifications and whatever. You can just create your own fucking terrier that never existed. It's great. It's got a numbering. It's got a lettering system, the OCR ones. You can actually choose what letters go where. A dynamic numbering system or lettering system that you can choose what the hell you want.
Oh.
I do have a question about the terriers, actually.
Oh, dear. Go on.
Will there be a porter's head?
They're going to do a poll, they said in one of their posts, about what other things that want to be included or whatever.
Because, yeah, because I would totally... I would be definitely interested if it came with porter's head.
Yeah.
Great question for the win.
I think they're going to do a livery poll or something like that. I personally want, like, one of the contractors' liveries, like New Haven Dock Company.
Hmm.
Oh. Yes.
The other Chris is here.
Ah, right.
Oh, the other Chris.
The other Chris.
That's the other Chris.
By the way, seeing as I've actually managed to say where I am, we're at Axley, by the way. And look at it, it's very Axey. End of the line at the moment, this is. So we're going beyond here to the lovely realms of beyond.
It's Bed Bath and Beyond.
No, not
well,
Bath.
I need some kitchen sink.
For God's sake, Freddie, you're such a knobhead. No one likes you, God.
Oh.
Oh.
Don't be mean to Freddie. Freddie's a lovely person.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't say that, Tom. That's.
Let me guess, it's racist.
I was going to say ageist. Ageist?
You're ageist.
Oh.
Weegist.
Anyway, Gallon Moor, ladies and gentlemen, there's absolutely feck all here to interest anyone, so let's move right along.
Yay!
Shall I put my thing of what I'm interested in coming out very soon?
Go on, then.
So I am now, well, as much as I love the Southern dearly, I've been falling for the LNER again.
Yes, boy!
And the Greyston Railway. I'm very excited for the Y14 now after listening to the Transicor recordings that I've purchased recently. My God, is it a loud engine?
What, the Y14?
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's quite nice.
It's a lovely engine.
It is a lovely engine. Because I'm an Eleanor supremacist.
You certainly are.
I am.
Eleanor power.
Exactly, my lords.
But no, Southern's still a very special place in my heart, but Great Eastern. Oh.
In the bin.
Don't put Great Eastern in the bin, you scrub.
No, mate. Southern, put it in the bin.
Oh. No,
I still want first Scottish. Still Scottish for some reason.
There you go, going Trace is on YouTube again.
Yay. Yeah, but Chris, we know you're a Scotty boo, so...
Oh, he's got a good taste.
Quick, someone keep talking. I need this out of the video.
The train now arriving at platform 1 is the 1020 service to Clapham Junction.
Ow, Freddy. You know, for all the times you whinge about us being loud, you can be very loud yourself.
I know. Right, we're going to take a short ref break at Gallon Junction because I need to check the point work. And I see Mr. Smash in his car again. What? He's always there. Go back to the workshop, you bum.
No, I'm polishing my car.
Why can I hear, like, you know...
Oliver. Is it Chris? You in your car, Chris?
I am.
Yeah, I can hear the road noise, mate.
Yeah, it didn't stop in time.
Oh dear.
Damn it.
Well, better, guys. I guess I'm gonna go, guys.
Okay. See you later, Chris.
Alright, see you, Chris.
Hello.
Oh.
Hello. And now we've been joined by another Chris.
Ah, right, okay.
The other Chris.
Interesting, we're now going to have to reverse the train.
Hooray!
Because I didn't brake quickly enough, so in order to get where I need to be going, I need to reverse the train a bit.
You introduced the loco as 47525.
Did I?
Yeah, but you didn't mention his name.
Well, why did I mention... No, wait. I wouldn't have mentioned 47525. I would have said 47527.
That's it. Yeah. 527. So, since Tom didn't mention a name at the beginning, his official name is something completely different.
I've already mentioned this before, I think, Bruce, but go on, carry on.
City of Kettering.
Well, no, Kettering it was called.
Was it? City of Kettering.
No, it was just called Kettering.
Oh, that's interesting.
My name is just Harry. Well, just Harry.
Well, yeah. God,
well
no.
Just Harry, you are a wizard.
So, what was I going to say? Oh, fuck me, this train's long. For this next part of the journey from... where are we? From Gallon Junction. Oh, look, we're on bench.
Oh, yay, dear, it's my bench.
Look, we're on bench. Anyway, from here to Cole Harper, we're going to window hang.
Triggered.
My lords.
So what I'm going to do is also put the handbrake on. I'm going to rev the engine up. And then we're going to do a super duper start. Ready, steady, handbrake off, and...
Whee!
Oh my god.
It's confirmed, Tom's up.
Ah! Thank you.
How can you not be a basher of spoons?
And again, they are quite nice, yeah.
Spoons are love. Especially this spoon is very spoony.
I'll tell you what, they're quite nice with Rella yogurt.
In terms of saucers, you'll never beat Peaks.
Oh.
Oh yeah, well, Peaks.
I think you'll find that Raymond would beat one in a race every day.
No, 40s.
To be honest.
Because he's Hellfire.
Well, the difference is Peaks were designed to be higher speed endurance as such. So they'd wind up to about 90, 100 mile an hour, and that's where they'd happily sit all day. It just took them a long time to accelerate there.
Oh.
I prefer the 40s.
I prefer 25s.
But does anybody prefer 20s? Triggering everybody.
Yes, choppers.
Yeah, 220s together, it's a Chinook.
Oh, I honestly thought I'd trigger some people now. I guess everyone's over the whole you killed him.
Oh, Cammer!
No, we're not.
Oh.
We're not. We're just trying to keep minimum.
Wait, you said two. That means Cammer and Jason.
Yeah, Jason had a barbecue that night.
No, too soon. Even I don't know when he died.
Oh.
I'll tell you what, it turned my floppy disk into a hard drive. Oh.
I don't get that.
And then it goes into a memory stick.
Bruce, it went from soft to erect.
Oh, right. What, the joke?
No, the game.
No. Yeah. I know what you mean, but why would the... never mind.
I don't know. It's a developer joke. It's perfect sense. Software,
it's not a developer joke, it's an IT joke.
Yeah, IT joke, whatever. It's software, hardware, if you want.
Barbie biscuitware.
Turn myself to hardware.
Gwion, I didn't know you felt that way.
My mic now, I'm not too loud.
Oh, by the way, once this video is actually recording, the other video that I made up.
Yay.
So if you guys want to quickly watch that without... Actually, it doesn't matter if you mute, don't mute it, but try not to let sound come onto Discord.
Fair enough.
Because that would ruin everything.
Well, not really, because they have a royalty-free music video, but it's just it'll be caught up on the audio and it will ruin the video.
Oh, wow, I see.
It would be funny if you got a copyright strike on your own video for your own copyright.
Well, it's not my music, you see. It's the YouTube's
free music.
But
that.
I know, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
To be honest, Tom isn't as incompetent as the Linus Media Group.
What's that meant to mean?
Oh, they've copy-striked their they've done copyright strikes on their own videos by accident.
Okay, you said the other day, I remember.
Oh, was that Warner Brothers or something?
No, Linus Media Group. It's a Linus Tech Tips and Channel Superfun and Tech Quickie. They're all owned by the Linus Media Group.
I'm kind of now eating pizza, so talk among yourselves.
Pizza, man.
I've just had a very interesting idea. Well, has anyone here seen Railway Roundabout?
Yeah, I have.
Railway Roundabout of the DR.
It's funny you've mentioned that, because I'm kind of planning on doing something like that, but I'm doing another thing, which is like a documentary type thing.
Oh, I see.
That would be quite cool.
But it's for patrons.
Okay, it's for patron, not matron.
No.
So it's another Patreon advert right here.
No,
yes.
That means horrible for me, damn it.
Again, pay as little as $1 a month to receive.
Are you tired of paying for toilet paper? Well, look no further.
Are you tired of Gwion trying to make his advert thing and Freddy coming in and ruining it? Then donate to Tom's Patreon to shut Freddy up.
Oh.
Brutal.
Also, you'd have to have the music to go to the back of the ad, like do 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 do. Yeah, I don't know if that's copyright, so I'll stop there before the 10 seconds comes up.
No.
Tom's making me sad.
Oh, grow a pair.
No.
But yeah.
What was that? A crow a pair.
Yeah, Tom's grow a pair.
Do I look like a tree?
Yeah.
Yes.
But he's an apple tree, not a pear tree.
Yeah, anyway, I'm going to watch Railway Roundabout a bit more and I might try and do a feature like type thing for that on the DR. But the documentary style thing is more, it's going to be like a basically similar to the video I've just linked, but longer, and it has more of an explanation of things with a proper narrator and shit.
All right, okay. That sounds pretty cool.
Almost like a precursor, you could call it. Anyway, we're coming through Cole Happer, as it currently stands. So, next stop, Horton. So I better go and make sure the track works all right. Anyway, so carrying on. That might be fun.
I do have a question about the way roundabout, actually.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was released in the 60s, and then it was re-released with kind of like redone narration.
Yes, with the NRM's permission, I think, wasn't it?
Yeah. Like, you could tell an update with more modern info, like on different engines and where they were and such.
Oh, yeah.
What was the original Railway Roundabout like? Because I only have the redone ones.
I actually have no idea.
I've got the redone, or I've got it on DVD, but I don't know if that means it's the redone version.
Well, the thing is, I don't think it had the narrator who narrates Railway Roundabout. You know that. In 1957, this was the swan song of steam. Doesn't have that narrator, I don't think. Didn't even have a narrator in the beginning, I'm not sure.
I thought it had the horse racing bloke from Channel 4 narrating it.
You sure that's... It might have. I have no idea.
I've only ever seen them. The horse racing bloke from Channel 4.
You know which one I mean. He's narrating many railway things. The nutcase with the big flowing hair, the glasses, and some weird dresses, and he's always over bloody. Oh my god! Oh, the hell,
I like to wear dresses.
The top, the bits of a nutter. You know that guy.
But I thought all horse racing reporters were a bit nutty.
Okay, yeah, have a point.
Just to interrupt, sorry. For those who have the DR1960s route, where I'm going through in a minute is literally as far as that route goes. So everything like from here is brand new. Unless I've done a video before, can't remember if I've gone to Hitchin Abbott before.
Yeah, you have.
Okay, well, thanks, Anthony. You ruined everything.
Yeah, good. Hooray.
But the next section line is brand new. Because we're going to Horton and that's not been seen yet in a video.
Oh, I like the way you've tagged in a video at the end of that very quickly.
It hasn't been seen yet.
Well, by Nazis.
I know something you didn't do, Tom.
What?
You didn't show off the charger, did you?
What, at Gannon Junction? Yeah, I did.
Dang it. I tried to be clever.
And I'll show you your one when we get to Horton.
Ooh. Nice.
Must be something wrong with it, seeing as it's in the mechanic bay. Ha!
Yeah.
Anyway.
I can't. Yeah, go ahead.
So, did you guys say we're on the triangle?
Oh, nice. I was going to say that's what happens when I let you test drive it.
Let's hope no engines go missing in that triangle.
No engines were harmed in the making of the triangle.
Like, yeah, sure. Chris's charger is slowly but surely being converted into a Prius.
Freddy, do you want to boot up your ass?
No.
Good.
No, the charger is slowly getting upgraded into a bicycle.
You can't mess with a charger. It's already perfect. Isn't that right, Tom?
Mm-hmm. Watch me.
Actually, you can make a charger better by making it USB compatible.
Oh my god.
I was going to say you could make it better by painting it orange, having an O1 on the
no!
side.
No! No!
No!
No!
No!
They
built so many chargers, it's not even funny. They had to modify cars to look like chargers.
Yeah. You had to modify 68 and 70 chargers to look like 69 chargers. But still, that's great enough for 68 and 70 charging too.
Mm-hmm. That sucks. They're so beautiful.
Went on the single track line to Horton. Yeah.
I'm gonna lie, I always preferred the Challenger myself.
Oh, don't get me wrong, I love Challengers. Challengers are cool.
Yeah, same.
So Plymouth Roadrunners, isn't that right, Chris?
Yeah, Plymouth Roadrunner. Should I bring that up, that I have a 72 Roadrunner?
He's a cunt for it, though.
My dad has, and I'm going to get it off him when I get a little older and have experience behind the wheel. And then I'm going to take it down to Bournemouth and let Tom have a test spin.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's on video. Now you can't say anything.
Damn it.
What? To translate for those who didn't understand what Chris meant was, he's going to wait until his father dies and then inherit the car.
No, I'm actually going to get it while he's still alive.
Yeah, I know that. I was just twisting it.
For anybody who's alive! If anybody wants to kill Bruce, please write to Bruce's Banterbus service at brucesbanterbus.co.uk.
That's not a legitimate website.
I think it is.
Yes,
I think I'm going to
buy it. I'm going to buy it.
I just made it.
Oh.
Sure. Just put the end / Arriva Trains Wales.
No,
don't worry, Tom. I'll let you have the roof for $1. Wink, wink, hint, hint. Or pound if you want.
You know I'm recording it, don't you, Chris?
I know. I didn't say anything. I'm just saying. That's all. That's all you have to give on Patreon. Wait, what?
Wow.
Remember, $1 a month. That's all you need.
No. $1 a day keeps a Thomas away.
Yeah, stop me making these videos. So I keep bugging people for Patreon.
Does $1 away keep the shitty CGI stuff away as well?
That could work.
Guys, I don't care that I said earlier on about this, like, not mentioning people, but I'm going to mention this anyway. I'm not mentioning a person, but $1 to Tom's Patreon a day stops advertisements on AWP.
Oh, snap.
Oh, dear.
Well,
Hashtag yeah. controversial, hashtag sacked as admin.
hashtag I'm taking over, hashtag.
I think that's a viewpoint that could actually be construed as sensible on Outlook.
Brampton Heath Station, by the way. Anyway, carry on.
I get where you're coming from.
Mm.
Well, all I'm going to say really on the subject because of the video, I mean, Reese is probably I don't know whether Reese will watch this, but anyway, if Reese is watching this, we have noticed a little bit that a lot of stuff has been shared. We're sure that now you're back, it's going to stop. Or at least produce a bit, unless it's really, really interesting. But yeah,
you share too much shit.
Yeah, basically.
Post shit, and also, get banned.
And also, Reese, watch that goddamn Halloween special.
Sorry, Chris.
No worries. Watch that goddamn Halloween special and make it live.
No, he's not doing it live. Okay. He's already said he's going to do it
pre-recorded.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, even better then.
When did he say he's going to do it?
Soon, I think.
Hmm. That reminds me, what I was going to say earlier, maybe Tom would one day get enough money via Patreon that he'd actually be able to film this live.
Yeah.
And use proper CGI teams, and maybe one day we wouldn't have to even look at a shitty rendering of a train.
Hey, it's not that bad. It's just terrible.
Again, well, for $1 a month, you can support Tom's to Patreon.
You lot could put your dollars where your mouths are.
No.
Well,
exactly.
You don't.
Anyway, Chris says your charger.
Nice.
Tom, I have a request.
What?
Trains on the Shelf to make a comeback.
Yes.
My boy.
I'm sorry, but since me and BBC took over it,
guys, really sorry, but just because I'm obviously recording a video in the room. Gantries! Yes.
Yes.
Fucking love gantries.
Now, before we continue on, you said put your dollar on your mouth. Tom, I already put 5 of them.
I know that, Chris. Not about you. I'm on about Anthony.
May have to stop for a short while.
Well, I was going to give you some, but guess what? You don't take Scottish fivers or tenors. Bastards.
Not legal tender.
It's legal tender. Oh, exactly.
Yeah, but Chris, as you've already contributed some, you're still a Patreon, technically.
Yes!
No, well, it's only because I'm saving money for the trip to Bournemouth. That's the only reason I might have to stop for a while.
Well, thanks for keeping broadcasting where I live. It's, you know, really pleasant. Now I'm going to get a load of people on my doorstep like, Tom, penis, Chom?
Well, to be fair, Tom, I didn't say you lived there. I was only saying I'm going to Bournemouth. I didn't say you lived in Bournemouth.
Yeah, but
nice to
now,
meet
mate.
You, Mr. Dark. Can I call you Chum?
By the way, we're now rolling into Horton Station, and I'm going to talk a bit about this in a minute, so wrap up what you're saying, and I'll carry on.
Right, basically, quickly, if we all donate $1, that works in our favour, because it's now only worth about 20 pence.
Oh.
I'll tell you
Thanks
what.
For the support, Brucey boy.
Don't worry, I'll chip in, by the way, as well.
You're going to put chips in, guys. Putting chips in for the lads.
Dollar is what I need.
Stop singing.
Don't sing, Freddy.
Yeah, don't sing. It's illegal.
And also, if you donate $1, you don't lose the game.
Right. We're now at Horton Station, which I think is probably one of the best layout areas I've actually done, because I'm just going to move the camera out. What you got is... where you got that? well, you got the DR platform here, eventually. And then they've got a little bay platform and a little area here. And they obviously have control of that goods yard over there. But then you've got these four lines here that run through the four platforms and the fifth goods line. Now, their third rail, which I think is fucking awesome. I've actually got some third rail 7 on my route.
Finally.
And some gantries.
Yep.
And, And you've also got... people can tell this is Exeter St. David's reskinned. How do you know it's reskinned? Because it's green on here instead of brown. Yeah.
Southern Railway green.
Oh, Gary.
Don't Dung.
Oh. That's a good shout.
Anyway, let's burp. Yeah. That's a great idea. Let's get run around so we can go to Hitch and Abbas and finish your cab ride.
All these bloody bones. Sausage.
Sausage.
Sausage. Yeah. Bombay.
Oh, I have to say one thing.
Mormon.
Delete this.
By the way, everyone, look at the glorious Raymond. Look how glorious Raymond is.
You look shit.
Oh, it looks amazing. I can't see.
I would enjoy if I could see, you bastard.
Well, you don't understand that I can't let you obviously fucking see it unless I was live streaming, which, of course, if you donate to me again, I can get better internet. Yay!
Yeah. Fun fact. Sorry to interrupt, I was going to say, fun fact, to let this is Norwegian for good morning.
Is it?
Yes.
No. Yes.
Good morning is Norwegian for good morning.
What?
Oh shit!
What the fuck did you see, Chris? I'm just scared of you. Come on, fight me! Fight me, Chris!
Sam, Chris. Am I gonna have to uninstall Scotland and reinstall it again?
Yeah, do it. Yeah, it's a big
would
one.
You like to uninstall Scotland and reinstall it elsewhere? For example, the Philippines.
Would you like to uninstall the Act of Union?
Would you like to uninstall Scottish independence? I really want to make that chromosome joke.
Don't.
Do it.
I'm not gonna.
Don't.
Okay, anyways. Scottishindependence.exe not found.
Would you like to save a file on diagnosing?
Would you like to send an error report? Microsoft Windows missile launcher has encountered a problem and needs to close. Do you wish to send an error report? Yes, but I haven't got time!
Well, Scotland, at least Raymond is flying off the rails today.
They're all picking on the Scottish. I'll sit. Fuck you, cunts. I'm with him.
Sam, you're so Scottish, it's unreal.
I know, I'm so Scottish. I play bagpipes.
Sam, look at it this way. Before you arrived, I was the one getting the shit taken out of me for being a Norwegian.
I just fire a buck. I'll just insult you.
Yeah.
And shit.
That's what I like about you, Sam. You fire back.
That's why I'm Scottish.
Does he fire blanks?
Yeah, you fire blanks.
No.
Because they don't do jack shit.
I've got a joke.
We'll see, Chris, my boy.
Yeah, right. We'll see next summer.
Leeds.exe has stopped working and has started claiming benefits. Would you like to save a file?
Oh.
Wait, has started what? Friends with benefits?
No.
No.
Leeds.exe
has stopped working. Would you like it to stab someone?
That's my job, Bruce.
Oh, no, I've got one. Branchline X stopped working. Would you like to install beachings?
Oh.
Acton Mainline has stopped Acton Mainlining.
Oh, don't. Acton Mainline for the win. Everyone loves Acton Mainline.
Also, head Paddington.
Everybody wants a six-pack.
Wait. Did someone say everyone wants a six-pack? Yeah, 440 six-pack, Cuda. Plymouth Cuda.
Oh.
Yeah, please.
Hang on, guys.
Why? Now I have your attention. God damn it.
There's a Lawrence typing in the chat.
Okay, Guion.
On it.
He's not in any voice channels, by the way, so...
Oh, well, find out what he wants and then tell him he's a scumbag. Meanwhile, just reversing back onto our train with Raymond and his massive snowplows. Ha ha ha, you bang snowplows.
Lol. BJ.
Anthony, really?
That was completely by accident.
What's he done?
Yeah, bullshit. He said BJ to Lawrence.
Oh my god, Anthony, I didn't know you swung that way.
Oh.
And silence fell again.
Well, said Pat.
Put a thing.
Could you fix it for me?
That's kind of fucked up from Lawrence, but I'm not going to say it out loud in this chat, because Tom will
burn me. You.
You could say Stuart just fiddled that joke.
Oh. Well, guys, we've now run around the train. We're now at the other end, and we're now going to head back towards Kolhapa, but instead of going towards Kolhapa Station, we're going to go towards Brentman and Santon and Hitchin Abbas. So let's go.
The last thing to say is, cheerio!
Are we catching a bus at Hitchin Abbas?
Ooh. Hitching a bus.
Wait, what's fun about that? What's funny about that?
Hitching a bus.
Oh.
Hitching a bus.
You have to show the absolute awesome speed that this train can leave the station. Ready? Oh, okay. It wasn't as impressive as I thought. I thought it was more impressive than that.
Sorry, Glenn?
I'm not going to lie. That joke gave me Southern Rail.
Oh. So it gave you a strike.
Between the timetable and reality.
That fucking joke gave me Thomas the Tank Engine CGI edition.
Oh.
It cannot be funny, guys. If a stagecoach bought Southern, just saying. It'd be a lot better.
They're part of the Go Ahead group, you spastic. They already practically own them.
That's not nice.
Aww.
Don't say the bad word.
Wait, hang on, Bruce, am I correct in that? They're part of Go Ahead. SR are part of Go Ahead along with Stagecoach.
No, Go Ahead aren't part of Stagecoach. Stagecoach has no involvement in it.
No, because Bruce is more knowledgeable in this subject, so I'd rather have his confirmation.
Please derail train so I don't have to drive this boring route anymore.
What were you driving?
I'm driving on a little island route project platform. With that American shunter, and I'm going to see how ridiculously fast it can go downhill and see if I can derail it.
You're on Peninsula.
Bye, Hitchin. Bye, Horton.
Bruce?
Oh, the kitchen's gave up? Sorry, the carriages gave up before the loco did.
Well, I'm driving Tom's favourite engine in the world.
Oh, no.
I'm driving a Black 5.
Oh, that's what I am.
JK, it's Flying Scotsman.
lovely locomotive. Listen, Flying Scotsman is quite good.
Get the fuck.
No, listen, right? I don't like him because Flying Scotsman because of its name. I like it because it's class.
No, you like it because it's called Flying Scotsman and you're Scottish. So,
No, it's not.
Moran.
Didn't you fucking start? Right. Didn't you start?
Moran. Right?
Didn't you start? He's already had his dinner.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And besides, the only reason I drive Flying Scotsman at all is because I want to crash it and burn it and never see it again.
It's Salmon Trout. Get it right.
We should say Humanist or Robert the Devil or Palantine.
You're all retards.
We're not retards, Anthony. It's Salmon Trout. Get over it.
Scotsman is love. Scotsman is life. And Scotsman is the subject of my best thing ever.
Salmon Trout.
You know what? You know what, Anthony? That's it. You're done.
Dinner.
Get out.
No, hang on.
Oh, I'm not repulsed.
Anthony, before you leave, Anthony, I have a question.
I don't think Anthony's actually going, but...
What is love?
For God's sake!
Baby, don't hurt me.
Don't hurt me! No more!
Shameless plugging certain members in this group. If you go to a site called Railwork Shed, you can find lots of A3 and A4 reskins.
Oh, which ironically were done by me. Oh, dear.
Exactly.
Oh, dear.
Were they?
Yeah, yep. I did the A3 reskin.
Oh, wow. Which Scotsman do you require for it?
Scotsman.
What, me?
Because I don't know if I... This is what I don't understand. I don't know if I've got a double 10 Scotsman. Which bloody Scotsman I've got?
Ah, right,
the one with a double tender.
You got a double tender one. Right, that comes with the old Flying Scotsman pack anyway.
Not the black one.
No, not the racist
one. That's racist.
Right, you know if I've got the racist version, then what happens?
You can't use it.
Right, okay.
Because I don't have the racist version.
Well, that's kind of racist.
Lies.
Spread by the government.
I love this. When you use an asset block in Railworks, right, it only loads when you get near it, so I have a massive stutter on my screen, and then it all appears.
It's the attack of the turbos.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Plus four.
Suddenly,
is
Leslie's on the tracks well ahead of you.
No, he's not on the tracks ahead.
That's a dead meme.
Well, he doesn't want Tom to succeed, and I don't want the meme to succeed, so hopefully he's not there.
Well, you've just made the meme succeed by mentioning it, you garbage. Yeah, cheesecake.
Well, I'm already taking that meme. Can't use it again. Dang
right,
it.
We're back. We're back at the triangle. Just so you know.
Illuminati confirmed.
So God, we're now about to take the loop round and to join up to the what is eventually the DR main line to a plane called Barbon, but at the moment it only goes as far as Hitchin Abbas.
Bourbons.
You're Bourbon.
Tony Blair was snorting coke in the brake van. Suddenly, Henry crash, and then world peace ensued.
The end.
You better thank God I wasn't in the brake van.
Yay, more gantries. Hello, gantries. Hello!
What would you be doing?
Oh, you should have been in a DRPS from the Starbase.
Wait, Bruce knows what happened.
No, he doesn't.
No, I don't.
About what?
The brake man.
One at a time.
Brake man incident.
Oh, yeah. What, with Chris? Oh, yeah. Ha ha ha.
You dirty boy.
Basically, Bruce, our own Chris here decided in best interest to go and have a dump in the brake van that we're restoring.
Defecate.
Yes.
Why?
Because you couldn't find a toilet.
Okay.
That's a bit of a shitty story. I know you live in Norway, but still.
Okay, listen. Well, can I just explain what happened so that people who are not in the DRPS understand?
Well, before you do, Chris, I just want to do something interesting, right? I'm about to enter Kolhapa Tunnel. I want to see, because it's about 2 miles long, I want to see if you can relay the story before I get to the end. So,
shit.
3, 2, 1, go, go, go!
Pretty much what happened is Tom said that it smells like shit in the brake van, and I said, well, sorry, I had to go somewhere. And then it just escalated from there, and he started putting it in the chat like, Mr. Rasmus inside a shit in the brake van. And then it escalated longer and longer until it pretty much ended with him chasing me down with a shovel as Mr. Smash.
And I almost fell off my chair.
Yes, laughing.
And dying. Okay, you finished that story in like 3 seconds, so... Yeah, we're still in the tunnel.
Okay, so...
I'm riveting.
Wait, what I'll do, Chris, is I'll just slow-mo this bit, just like... So when I had a dump in the brake van.
Wait, Tom, you had a dump in the brake van too?
No.
Join the club.
No.
We're in the tunnel. You could also say. Oh, go ahead. Sorry.
I forgot about that.
While we're in the tunnel, has anyone got any spooky stories? Yes.
I've got a spooky story.
Okay.
Right? Mormons.
Oh.
Honestly, you can trust them.
I have an even scarier story. Cameron Colin Owen.
Dead.
You guys ready?
I have a scary story.
Okay, well, thanks for that, everyone who introduced Freddy again.
Once, there was a developer. His name was...
Can't say it.
Mr. Gobter. He made engines so bad that everyone died. The end.
It wasn't exactly scary.
I've got an even scarier story.
All right, Ingle okay. Nod.
Once upon a time, there was a little engine called Cheapside. It died after smashing into an LBSCRG class. The end.
Well, I'll
be sleeping tonight.
I just thought the most scary story ever.
What?
I've got a jar of dirt.
Oh.
Yeah, you can.
I have the worst one.
Go on, then.
I have a girlfriend.
Oh my god.
No, I don't have a girlfriend.
Oh, guys.
LOL.
Does my hand count as my girlfriend?
Yes.
Yay.
I think we need to all go and I think we all need to go and trap ourselves up with some bombs and go and have a Alahoot snack bar.
Ooh, nice.
Well, before we do that, I am going to look up a script and then I'm going to read it out to you.
Is it Gary the Steam Engine episode 1?
I wish it was.
Yep, oh, there's a light at the end of the tunnel! Oh, wait, it's because we're at the end of the tunnel. Awesome.
No, Tom, it's because there's another train coming your way.
Oh. Clearly not.
And it's called Abdul. Allahu Akbar!
Racist.
No, it's slightly racist.
I know.
You should feel sorry about that.
Darth Zeb the Sith Lord said there's a train in the hole in the road.
What?
Not stupid fucking, for Christ's sake.
Who did TTS?
TTS World.
Oh, shit.
What?
Fuck is TTS?
It's Zeb did TTS today.
Right, Anthony, I got it.
Wait, what's going on?
Well, at the moment, we've just climbed out of the tunnel at 35 miles an hour because Raymond can't climb hills. Clearly. Bastard.
I'm so sorry.
I can't help it.
How steep is that gradient?
It's 1 in 101.
Oh.
45 101.
It's even worse.
It's
even worse the other way coming from Hitch and Abbott to Brentwell and Santon because it's a 1 in 45, I think, on one bit for about half a mile.
I've got it, guys. Ahem. I need some water, actually, so I can read this script.
Oh my god. It better be interesting, otherwise it will kill you.
You're anxious. It's about to get sticky.
Ready, quickly drink water, otherwise you'll drop a fusel.
I think Anthony may have lost connection, guys.
Well, if he comes back in, then I'm sure Gwion can drag him back in.
Yeah, he's in another chat. There he goes.
Oh.
Yay.
Hey, Anthony.
Don't worry, Anthony.
I might change the names a little bit just for the giggles.
Before you start, Freddy.
Yeah.
Just want to point out, I'm coming over what I think are probably one of the best scenery areas of the route, which is Brentwell and Santon Station, where you've got the viaduct for the branch line that's building over there. You've got this lovely embankment that we're rolling along now, and it's just lovely and scenery. So, yeah, here we are at Brentwell and Santon. So carry on, because I'm going to just go through the station and then go down the big hill.
Gwion is a tank engine who lives on the island of...
Whoa! Swansea.
God's sake!
He has six small wheels, a short
he
funnel,
lives on the island.
A short funnel, fucked it up,
A short funnel.
And a short cock.
And dumpy dump cocks.
Thank you.
Oh, sugar, 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 sugar. Please be fine. We're going to go slightly further than Hitchin Abs, actually. We're going to go across the embankment, because that's one of the best bits.
Oh, you absolute devil.
Oh, well, you should pay the banking clan.
And now we're at the summit of this part of the line, and on to the lovely one in 45. Time to go fast.
So you have a 1 in 45 and a 1 in 101.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Coincidence?
I think not.
Is it 1 in 45? Let me just double check. How can I... Yeah, it is 1 in 45. Lovely. Haha.
45, 101. Huh. Wonder who that is.
Because Raymond's so shit at picking up speed, let's accelerate down this incline. Oh, there's a signal right in the way! Ah, fuck! Oh, okay. it's alright, this part of the route was originally single track and I had to double it, and some of the signals are still on the wrong side of the line.
Perfect for the Western cruise.
No, what I meant was it's actually in the middle of the line I'm running on.
Oh.
My lord's fwack.
Right, I think we're approaching as well, because this is some lovely scenery out here too. I wish the rest of my route looked like this. Yeah. Coming up to another platform, which I haven't named yet, but it's like a developed platform that we rebuilt at some point, and a little township will be built nearby. Ah, 25 limit in the middle of the rails! Ah, boom!
You did not.
I'm actually going at 81 miles an hour, so it doesn't really matter.
Oh. You didn't derail, did you?
No, I didn't derail. Okay, so the station, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Let's carry on. Engine double check. When I get to Hitch and Abbas, am I going to get straight... Lag! I hate the computer so much.
Yeah.
Cough, Patreon.
I think time for another Patreon update, Gwion.
It is. Yes.
For at least $1 a month, you can help support Tom with his Patreon to build a new computer. By supporting him, you will get many benefits like early videos or even special videos that are viewed that are exclusive to Patreons only.
And income support, seeing if we're claiming benefits here.
Yes.
Well, shit. And merchandise exclusively for Patreon. For pastry.
For Patreon, did you say, Anthony?
For what?
You said for Patreon.
Patreon.
And also, if you, get to become a Patreon mom, you can either get the message tone, oh shit, from Anthony, or cheerio from Anthony.
Cheerio!
Or we'll try and make a ringtone, a text tone, that when you get a text message, it goes, you're welcome!
Not only that, you get yourself a special TDRS Patreon supporter tag on our Discord server.
Ooh.
Yeah. And for just £25 billion a month, all that could be yours.
Sounds like a deal. Where do I go?
You go to Scotland. You go to Scotland and shout more then.
I can do that. Oh, I do it every day, Tom.
Okay.
Well,
I think Oliver wants to say something.
You need to put some emphasis into it and like some. You need to put some emphasis and emotion into it.
What do you mean, like your voice?
You're presenting your Patreon ads as a salesman.
Do you mean your voice?
Watch this. This is how you get the monies in. Life. It's hard for everyone.
You just sound fucking depressed.
For a young man growing up in Bournemouth.
Oh my god.
For $1 a month, you can make the life of a Bournemouth man
a little
easier. Donate now to Thomas Dibden's Patreon.
And you say my intro.
That's how you do it.
That was shocking.
That was absolutely shocking. Go in the corner.
Life, it's really sad. Why don't you just get Morgan Freeman to do it?
Where are you from, Blade? Birmingham.
I tell you what.
Yes.
I'm from Birmingham. We speak like this.
There's a very simple way of doing of getting people to do it. Fucking pay Tom fucking money, right?
I'll do it. Right. Pay Tom money fucking right now. Do it or I'll come to your fucking house.
Jesus Christ, Tom, right. Tom, you get £100 every month. Are you happy?
I want to do that as an actual advert on DDJP channel.
I was going to go along the lines of, hey, give me all your money, but I'm not going to go there.
I don't think you should go there because I think, as we've already pointed out tonight, someone's already basically done that again.
Rip off cunts. Oh.
Right, so this bit here is essentially where the scenery ends for the DR, so I'm going to stop here on the embankment.
Who's eating?
Everyone's eating, because we're all fat.
I'm not fat.
Yeah, you are, Anthony, don't lie.
I'm just big bone.
Bullshit! It's like communism. Everyone is fat, except some are more fat than others.
What is this?
With greed.
Welcome to Soviet Russia, where Anthony sells money.
To sum up,
the animals look to the pigs, and then to the humans, and then back to the pigs again.
This is essentially the end of the line scenery-wise for now. As you can tell from earlier parts of the DR, scenery-wise down this way is a lot nicer. Yay.
If you want to see more scenery down there, pay for time and put money in.
God's sake! And as you can tell, the railway line goes, excuse me, to about there, and then stops. So that's like the end of the line. Oh, back of my job.
Because love isn't always on time, Tom.
No. I've got a better campaign.
You lost the game?
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any spare change, you would normally donate to a sad, rotting corpse of a child.
Whoa,
in the deepest, darkest, graves of Syria. You can always brighten your life without giving yourself crippling depression at the thought by donating your money to Tom Dibden's Patreon. You get fantastic videos, free merchandise and everything else, and you get to see kids die.
Oh, well, that took a turn.
Terms and conditions apply. Kids don't actually die in Bournemouth. Kids actually die in other parts of the world. We don't care. Bye.
Oh. Well, as we're at the end of the line, I guess that's the end of this video. So.
Oh, God, that was the best advert ever.
That one's a great... But I want to do my own advert for DDJP.
Go on.
Hey. So give me all your goddamn money.
Well, thanks for ruining my advert, guys. Let me fucking finish. Give me your fucking money!
No! Not the Scottish Fivers!
Please give me money!
Please, I need it. I'm dying.
You're so poor. Oh, no.
Anyway, I'm actually going to finish here, so... Thanks to everyone who joined us for the call. We'll do more of this soon.
Right.
Everybody say bye.
You lost the game.
Bye.
And donate to Tom's Patreon.
Bye.
Hello.
Bye.